In closing, for part one, hopefully, you know, I'll come up with more questions at another time, but for this part of the interview, is there anything that you'd like to say or anything to wrap anything up about, you know, if you were going to talk to anybody or say any one thing to any person?
Well, in closing, I'd have to say, first of all, I thank God that's given me my health at this time, so many friends, and being able to see a park that was dedicated in my name. Usually they don't do that till a person is gone, and to see that I enjoyed it a lot with my family, and I still enjoy seeing my family, my great grandchildren, and my children, and every day that I know that they're around and I'm around, I enjoy that. And I think that's what I live for, and I'm so happy that I'm able to do that. And that in later life, that where I met this wonderful lady that's been a companion and makes a life easier for you. It's because it's a tough life living by yourself and looking at the four walls, even though you know people, you get to see them once in a while, but as you get older, you know, many of your friends passed away and you don't get a chance. And like Vic is still around, and maybe my brother and a couple others, but I made new friends, but they're friends, good friends, but they're not people that you spend your life with, you know. And I'm now there's like Jenny that I'm with. She's a wonderful person, and I feel like I got a new life. By that I mean, all my friends like her, my family likes her, her family likes me. So it's something beginning all over again, you know. For whatever time I've got, I appreciate that, because she's so wonderful. Like, she cooks a lot at the house, and what, you know, she cooks a lot, and she, and every time if I'm sitting there, she says, "You want something to drink?" She wants to wait on me hand and foot, you know. And she's helped me a lot, because I'm not the best driver in the world. And she's a great driver, and she does all the driving and stuff like that. And so, and I look forward to being with her, because, you know, she likes the same things I like. She being from Evergreen Park, she was in charge of the senior citizens. She met a lot of those people that know her. She knows a lot of people that are in Evergreen Park, and almost as much as I know. So we have something in common. And she's easy going, and we never had an argument. We've gone 3 years together, and we always agree upon. I always say, "Where do you want to go?" She said, "Why don't you decide where we want to go? Why do I always have to?" He says, "You make it sometime, you know." She's so easy going, you know. And I really like going, being with her, and gives me something to look forward to, you know what I mean? Instead of saying like when you see, if you're in a house by yourself, you know, sure, you got a neighbor, I don't know, I'm not close to these neighbors. And if Vic is somewhere and he's got to go, he's got a kid in California, he's got a daughter who lives downtown area, if sometime he goes with her, and it, you know, and then, and like my brother, like, he's laid up now, you know, but then where do I go, you know? Do I call Mary? The mayor, he's got his family, you know. When I meet him on special occasions, big things, that's, you know, that. And this fellow, Bill Gosden, I'm going with, he goes for 6 months or 5 months, he goes to Florida, but we're real close, you know. When he comes in, we see each other now, and we'll stay with each other for a while. But then, you know, he's got a big family too, you know, he goes. So you see, you got to be lucky when you got somebody like this, you know.